Now that we understood what an interface is, we'll move on to the next topic, abstract class.
Which is, what is the difference between an abstract class and an interface? So, we talked about an interface. Interface represents actions that a class can perform. What is an abstract class then? I mean, in interface, we cannot define the method, so they are abstract methods. So, is there any relationship between an abstract class and an interface? This is quite a common intuitive question that is asked. What's the difference between an abstract class and an interface? The first difference I would always talk about in terms of concept is an interface represents actions that a class can perform. So, all the names of the interface would be something like a action. So, runnable is an interface. Playable is an interface. So, those are all different actions. Whereas, the abstract classes are also classes. I mean, they're just a type of a class. So, the abstract classes represents a noun. So, abstract class is actually representing a noun. In terms of, it represents some object inside the problem domain. So, when I really get into the definition of an abstract class, the definition of the abstract class is that you cannot create an instance of an abstract class. So, if I call any class abstract, then it means I cannot do a new operator on this. So, I cannot say, now here let's say I am creating just a temporary variable. So, abstract class example test is equal to new abstract class example. This is not allowed because an abstract class cannot be instantiated. So that's what it's saying. Cannot instantiate the type abstract class example because abstract class cannot be instantiated. So an abstract class you cannot create an instance of an abstract class. So a lot of times you have a lot of common functionality between classes, between objects of the same type. Then you create an abstract class and put all the common functionality in there. But this common functionality might not be complete. I mean, you might need really to create a subclass to complete it. So, in those kind of scenarios, you will make the superclass as abstract. So, that's the scenario in which you would use an abstract class. When we really come to the syntactic differences between abstract class and an interface, in an interface, all the methods are by default, public, static, final. So, they are all public, they are all static and final. And all the variables that you declare there are also public, static, final. So, they are constants. In an interface, you cannot have an instance variable. They are all static variables. However, in an abstract class, you can have static variables, you can have static methods, and also you can have the definition of a method. So, you can define methods in an abstract class. In an interface, you cannot define methods. So, here I am defining what this abstract method should do. So, that's also another difference between an abstract class and interface. And another important thing is you can implement multiple interfaces. When you extend an abstract class, you can only extend one abstract class because you can only extend one class at a time in Java. But you can implement multiple interfaces. So, if this question comes up in an interview, the best answer to give is an abstract class usually is another class. So, it's a noun. However, interface represents actions like playable, runnable and all those kind of stuff. When it really comes to the syntax of the thing, an abstract class can contain definition of methods. An abstract class can contain non-static methods like instance methods. And an abstract class, you can only extend one instance of one abstract class. However, you can extend multiple interfaces. These are the most important differences between an interface and